Hi, this is Vishnu Subramaniam from jarvislabs.ai. We are very excited to launch our new deep learning course. We have designed this deep learning course in a very different way. You are going to learn deep learning by competing in a live Kaggle competition, which is going to end in another 1 month. Let's discuss why we choose Kaggle as a platform to learn deep learning. Kaggle has a great community of data scientists, AI researchers from different parts of the world, from different top organizations like Google, Lyft, Microsoft, Uber, and much bigger research organizations, a lot of different companies, and a lot of freelancers also come and actively participate in Kaggle competitions. A lot of different ideas from research gets early adoption in Kaggle competition, because in Kaggle competition a lot of data scientists try to compete for the last decimal 0.001 to win a gold medal. And in order to do that, people have to adopt the latest techniques. People sometimes go crazy on the number of GPUs they end up using. So there's a lot of learning that happens in Kaggle platform. The ability to work on different kinds of problems, starting from computer vision, image classification, segmentation, object detection, NLP question answer, NLP text classification, sometimes audio. I know of a recent competition where people are trying to identify the kind of a bird based on the audio sound. There are different kinds of problems that you can come across in Kaggle. Kaggle kernels also provide free access to GPUs and TPUs for a limited 30 hours per week. Why is this important? Many of you who wants to start deep learning journey, you may not have direct access to a high-end machine which has GPU or TPU. So to quickly start, Kaggle has got this kernels which lets you run the deep learning programs that we are gonna teach you on this course. Participating in Kaggle has two different mixed opinions. One set of opinion where people claim that it's not close to industry. Partially it could be true, some part of that is not close to industry, and there's other set of people who believe that participating in Kaggle actually improves their chance of getting hired, doing research, innovation, and a lot other things. So we at Jarvis Labs belong to the second group of people who believe in actively participating Kaggle helps you to learn deep learning and advance your deep learning skills. Let's see what top researcher in the AI space who built the fast AI framework and also an entrepreneur, Jeremy Howard. A few years back, there was an article in Katie Nedgett's, which was like a Q&A kind of session, where Jeremy Howard claims that he has learned much more in Kaggle, participating in Kaggle, than what he has learned in the last 20 years of his career. And to let you know what he has done in his career, he has worked in companies like McKinsey, starting from a very young age, 19 or 18, I'm not sure. And he started his own company, analytics company, and then he started his own medical startup. And now he runs one of the largest deep learning open source community called fast.ai. And we kind of are inspired by fast.ai top-down approach, and that's why we start this course with a complete pipeline to solve this classification problem, and then we step on one step at a time how to build each component of it, and then we end up this course with few different tricks that you can apply and probably win a medal in this competition. And about me, I'm founder of jarvislabs.ai. I have authored a book 2 years back. It's a bit outdated, so I would not recommend it for now. I've been a speaker. I've spoken in Analytics Summit, Analytics India with their conference, and I've been a Kaggle competition expert. Apart from this, I have also taught people about different frameworks like Spark, Hadoop, different libraries in data science. And I've mentored different teams. I've helped companies in implementing their AI projects and other big data related projects. And that's my son sitting with me. And let's, in the rest of the course, I strongly believe that we have enough places or opportunities to know better of each other. We'll also plan for some live sessions where we can interact with each other in these online times. What is our approach? Right, as I said, we are inspired by fast.ai's approach of top-down. We start with a pipeline which is pre-built using plain Python and PyTorch, which helps you build an image classifier. After looking at it at a high level, we build each of the components that we have seen as part of the high level from scratch, just using Python, PyTorch, and some basic libraries or some key libraries like NumPy, Pandas, nothing more than that. And we submit our first submission to Kaggle. Hopefully you should be somewhere in the top 30 or 40 percentage. And from there, we will help you with different tricks that you can use to improve your leaderboard score or to improve your model's performance on the competition. So the last part of teaching new tricks, this is a live competition and there are different people participating across the globe. To be fair for them, we will not be able to provide a complete solution, a workable solution. So this is where you start thinking like a hacker and where you understand the key concept and then try to implement it, try to play with hyperparameters to improve your metric. In this case, it's something called ROC. Sorry, it's called AUC metric. Let's look at these metrics in detail in the coming videos. What is the problem statement? We have spoken about the approach. We have spoken about who we are and what is the problem statement that we are going to try to solve. It's a very simple problem statement of image classification. If you have already learned deep learning, there's a very high chance you'd have applied a classification algorithm for identifying something like dogs or cats. If you're new to deep learning and data science, absolutely don't worry. We will, in the coming videos, we'll teach you how to build a classification algorithm using deep learning. So this competition is about a particular problem called melanoma. It's a cancer that can be found in skin. Okay, and we're going to build an algorithm that's going to identify whether a particular skin has got cancer or not. Why is image classification problem so difficult in the world of 2020? The reason is the data is highly imbalanced. That makes the problem very challenging than most of the toy problems or toy data sets that we typically learn deep learning with. So in the next couple of days, we will be launching a set of videos showing the pipeline and showing how to build the components of the pipeline, a Kaggle kernel, a collab. If you're new to Kaggle kernel or collab, don't worry, we will show you exactly how to do that so you can run these from your own machine. What are the prerequisites? We believe that anyone with the right curiosity and persistence can learn deep learning. So the only expectation that we have from you is you are comfortable with any programming language, preferably the modern programming languages. If you're comfortable with Python, that's a very good thing. The reason is the entire course is going to be on Python. Saying that Python, even if you do not know Python, please do not worry, as Python is a very simple language. And if you're stuck with some particular concept in Python, please comment on the videos or the forums that we would be creating in the coming days. And we would be happy helping you with some of the contents available probably in the open source, or if it's not available, then we will create some content for the same that can help you understand the particular concept. But saying that, Python is very easy, and we'll be using a framework called PyTorch, which is one of the most popular frameworks today for doing deep learning. The reason why we choose PyTorch, we will probably discuss in the coming videos. If you like this video and if you're in for participating in Kaggle competition to grab a medal, probably bronze, silver or gold, please like and subscribe our channel for future updates. Thanks for watching the video. Bye bye.